Hi, I'm Nigel Blake. I work for North Coast Local Land Services, and we're here today on the amazing Yaegl country. So I'd just like to acknowledge the traditional owners and the elders, past, present and future. The reason we're here on this property, because it's one of the 50 or so properties that have been involved in the Upper Coldstream Biodiversity Hotspot program. And that's a program that's been run by North Coast Local Land Services for the last 4 years, and it's been funded by the New South Wales Government Catchment Action Program. The Hotspots project is built on the great work done by Nature Conservation Council. That was in turn built upon some amazing landholders who have been involved with Land for Wildlife for over a decade now. Botanists who are involved with the project have identified over 1,100 different native plant species. With those different plants in this forested area here, we are finding a huge array of native animals living and inhabiting this part of the world as well. There's a number of reasons why the biodiversity is so amazing here, is the sheer scale. Here we have a forested area that covers thousands of hectares, interspersed with cleared area for farms and residences and other infrastructure. And therefore we've got viable populations of both forest types and native animals that are surviving and flourishing in the Upper Coldstream biodiversity area. The most important reason that we've got such biodiversity here is because of landholders. It's the landholders here that are totally committed to biodiversity and wildlife conservation on their own properties. And with the funding that we've received, we've been able to engage the Clarence Environment Centre's Bush Regeneration Team and the Yaegl Wadja, the Traditional Owners Land Management Team. And they've been concentrating mostly on weed control, primarily lantana. Once the large clumps of weeds are under control, then we get the property to a stage that the landholder can really easily keep on top of the weeds by just regularly patrolling and pulling them out as they emerge. And in that way, we've got the property to the state that's really easy to manage, and the biodiversity and habitat values are going to be maintained much more simply once the bush regen team have been in. One of the great things about this area too is that we've still got populations of native animals that aren't found in such numbers almost anywhere else on the planet, really. We've got the last remaining population of the coastal emus. We've got koalas, lots of the small mammals as well, the fasca gales and the squirrel gliders and the yellow-bellied gliders. And they are a food source for the large forest owls, which we know inhabit this area, and also one of the last viable populations in Australia, really. And interesting things like the giant dragonfly, which is found in very few places up and down the coast, and we can find them right here in the Upper Coldstream area. The reason we have viable populations of these mammals is because of the food source that's here. The Upper Coldstream has a really high nectar index, and that's relating to the nectar-bearing flowers of the eucalypts, the banksias and the bottle brushes. And because of the diversity of species, they're flowering at different times all through the year. So that means that the nectar-eating mammals and birds have something to eat for 12 months of the year, and that really gives them a much greater chance of survival.